world. We know that plants are living things. In our surrounding, we will see so many types of plants. And we also know the different parts of the plant. You already studied in your previous class. In third standard, you know you have studied about the different parts of a plant. Okay, student, recall which are the different parts of a plant. The different parts of a plant are root, stem, leaf, branches. These are all the different parts of a plant. Root, stem, leaves, branches. These are all the different parts of the plant. In that, the important part of the plant is leaves. In our surrounding, we will see different types of plant. In different types of plant, we will see the different shapes of the leaves. For example, I will show one example. See here. I think you all know this leaf. Okay, student, tell me this leaf belongs to which plant? This leaf belongs to the banana plant. The shape of this leaf is flat and long shape. Next. Like that, only another example is this is the mango leaf. The mango leaf have pointed ends. In different types of plant, we will see the different types of leaf. For example, in peepal tree, the shape of the leaf will be heart shape. These are the examples for different types of leaves. In different types of plant, we will see the different shapes of the leaf. Almost all the leaf color will be green. Next, parts of a plant are structure of leaf or parts of leaf. What I wrote on the notebook, you have to must and should copy in your book. Okay, student, along with me, you also copy this diagram. Leaf consists of flat part. This is the flat part. We call it as leaf blade. This part we call it as leaf blade. This part is a flat part. So we call it as leaf blade. Leaf contain flat part is called leaf blade or lamina. In the middle or in the center, we will see the thick line. This is the thick line. This line, we call it as midrib. may, where. We also call middle as may, where. In the leaf, it contains in the center or middle a thick line. That line we call it as may tree. Thick line present in the center of a leaf is called midrib.
They did also breathe.
cells. This is the function of stomata. In human beings, with the help of our nostrils, we will take the gas and also we will release the gas. Like us only, plant will also take the carbon dioxide and also release the oxygen to the atmosphere with the help of this stomata. This is about the meaning of stomata and also function of stomata. Stomata helps in exchange of gases. Next, functions of leaf. Leaves help in preparing the food for the plant by the process we call it as photosynthesis. For leaf, we also call it as food factories because leaf prepare food for the plant, so we call it as food factories. The first function of leaf is leaf prepare by the process of photosynthesis. We also call leaves are the food factories because they prepare food for the plant by the process we call it as photosynthesis. In next class we will discuss in detail about the photosynthesis. The next function of leaf is leaf helps in exchange of gases with the help of stomata. This stomata help in exchange of gases in leaf. Stomata helps in exchange of gases in plant. One more function is that in some of the plant, leaf stored as a food. For example, cabbage and spinach we directly utilize as a food. This is the functions of leaf. Once again, I am repeating the functions of leaves are leaf prepare food for the plant by the process we call it as photosynthesis. And also for the leaves we also call as food factories. Next, these leaves helps in exchange of gases with the help of stomata. One more function is that the leaf help leaf stored as a food which is directly we are utilizing as food. For example, cabbage and spinach. In today's class, we learn about the different types of leaf and also parts of leaf and also meaning of stomata and functions of stomata and also functions of leaves. Okay, thank you students.